still remnants of winter in Worcester. It's been since the middle of winter that Holy Cross last played a game at home. That was in their opener against Providence. And now, nationally ranked Army in the house to take on the Crusaders. And we say hello here from Kuznetsky Field alongside Dan McLaughlin, AJ Cannell, and Holy Cross and Army. Usually that means defense.
Absolutely. Last year, a 5-3 result. And this is an Army team nationally ranked at number 18, part of a stacked Patriot League. And the Black Knights are going to come in physical. Holy Cross has to respond to that. And talking about having the deck stacked against you, 29th meeting all time between these two squads. Army is 27-1.
And you look, and you mention a stacked league. Four of these teams are nationally ranked in the polls. You can add Colgate to that list as well in the standings. Holy Cross and Army, though, in this one. And players to watch, we start with Brendan Nickturn, a feeder on the Army side.
He's a solid goal scorer in his own right, but it is absolutely the assist where he makes his money. Nickturn had four in that matchup against Binghamton earlier this week. He owns a dog named Alpha, and that's fitting because he is very much the alpha dog of this Black Knight attack.
Meanwhile, a goal scorer for Holy Cross. He's increased his goal total every single season so far in his career, the junior Sean Mullaney.
Only had 10 last season. That's nothing to shake a stick at, but 13 already this year, including back-to-back hat tricks. It's a veteran team for Holy Cross. That's rare. Mullaney, very much the catalyst now, a junior looking to lead this attack with the graduation of Logan LeBlanc.
Holy Cross tops in the conference at causing turnovers. Army is supremely good at holding opponents without goals. Really, really great on the back line. The Black Knights and the Crusaders coming up next from Worcester here on NESN Plus. Feeling patriotic here on an early Saturday afternoon. Army and Holy Cross here in Worcester. Welcome back. Dan McLaughlin, AJ Cannell on NESN Plus. Army number 18 in the country, and here is the stat matchup. So good defensively are the Black Knights. They're tied for third in the NCAA in goals against per game.
Yeah, they're outstanding, but you look at this matchup graphic. Where is the opportunity for Holy Cross? It's at the X. The Crusaders and Dan O'Connell are outstanding, north of 57%, and Army winning south of 40% of their faceoffs. The Crusaders want to pull the upset here today, which they absolutely can do. As we saw against Harvard, they also played Loyola tough, a 19-15 result down in Baltimore. Holy Cross wants to pull the upset here today. O'Connell's got to be on. They need to take advantage of that mismatch.
Well, because Army is good enough that they're going to stop you most of the time, but really the battle seems to be, Dan, can Holy Cross generate enough possessions to get the requisite number of scores? Because on the year, two strengths of theirs have been causing turnovers and winning faceoffs, two things that lead to more possessions. If they struggle in either of those areas today, it could be tough to score the necessary amount against Army. AJ Barreto in goal for the Black Knights. Career high 18 saves and a loss at Syracuse earlier this season in late February. He is a senior from Darlington, Maryland, and he's one of the best to do it not only in the conference but in the country this year. Jonathan Tesoro is the goalkeeper for Holy Cross. He had a tough one at number one Loyola on March 2nd, gave up 19 goals, but bounced back in the loss against Bucknell last time out with 10 goals allowed and 13 saves.
And anytime you're north of 50% as a goaltender in men's lacrosse, you're doing something right. It's hard to put the Crusaders 2-4 record on Tesoro.
Dan O'Connell, the Fogo for Holy Cross, starts him right off with a face-off victory. O'Connell was kept in check in the Bucknell loss, and Holy Cross really struggled to maintain possession. This time O'Connell taking it right in, had it checked away from behind, and a push is called to actually leave it with Holy Cross, and O'Connell will go sub off.
Yeah, you see the swarming Black Knight defense there. They take the push, but Johnny Surtick and company are a very tough unit to crack. We mentioned at the top of the broadcast, 5-3 the result last year in West Point. No reason to think today is going to be any different. Expect a low-scoring defensive battle, and whoever capitalizes on their chances is who's going to come out on top.
Army took the win, but actually for the Black Knights in that game, that was their lowest goal total in either of the last two seasons. Tied for the lowest. Kodzis for Holy Cross, tied for the team lead in goals with Mullaney, who he featured in the open. Kodzis spinning back and forth. His shot save, got the rebound, and it's picked up behind the cage by Spangenberg. Shot clock has reset. Loose ball taken in by Mullaney.
And you'll see here, Holy Cross likes to press. They don't take much time cycling the ball around the perimeter. They're not looking for the skip pass and finding the gap. They're going to drive right in on Barreto, make him make two or three saves every single possession.
Well, based on the profile of Army's defense, how do you think that matchup will play itself out?
I think that Army needs to be crisp, and what it's going to come down to is if Army can be physical and be as effective as they can be with their stick checks without taking pushes, without taking slashes, you like the Black Knights' chances because they're so good with Surdick and Rigney and company. But if Holy Cross can force them to take some fouls, maybe get a man-up situation, that's where it gets dicey for a physical defense.
Some sloppy passes early for the Crusaders, but they've been very good at recovering some of these ground balls, in that case forcing another small foul on Army and getting the ball back. Waldron trying to dodge on the right alley. Linsky, again, the misconnection on the pass, and it was scooped up by Beyer. On the move all the way, it's saved by Tesoro on George's attacking play in transition.
And that's big for Holy Cross because they've had the ball in their attacking half the entire game so far. Then Army gets one breakout play. If Tesoro doesn't make that save, all the momentum immediately goes to the Black Knights.
Still, though, a strong start for Holy Cross to possess for about 2 minutes to begin the game.
Yeah, I think you'll take it. And as the Crusaders, one of the things they were looking to do there was take advantage of the matchups with the short sticks because Army, both their close defenders and their long stick midfielders are so good. If they're going to drive, it's going to be on the short sticks. The Black Knights were outstanding on that possession. And here, offensively for Army, they're going to look to do the same thing because Matt Farrell and company are the strength of this Crusader defense.
Garofano off to Alacqua. Alex Alacqua, junior midfielder. Now Manown with it once again. Back to Garofano. Thought about winding up. Fed it behind the cage instead. Quick cutter out in front. Stone by Tesoro. Nate Jones had that attempt for Army, and now there's a player shaken up. It looks like it is Jones.
Yeah, that's another opportunity there for Army. This one very different from the breakout play. Jones, a captain, he was an All-Patriot League second-teamer all the way back in 2016 as a freshman. Common theme, Army was outstanding back in 16. A.J. Barreto was also a second-team All-Patriot League player. As we get another look at this opportunity for the Black Knights, Tesoro, again, big for Holy Cross. We've talked about how good Army is defensively. The Crusaders are only giving up around 11 a game, and that's including that 19 spot against Pat Spencer in Loyola.
In what was only a four-goal loss, Holy Cross able to keep pace with the Greyhounds for most of that game. It was a one-goal game going into the fourth quarter.
Yeah, and they held Spencer to three goals. I know that doesn't sound like much, but he's probably the best offensive player in the country this year. So, yes, they did struggle a little bit with Kevin Lindley, who had six. But you hold Spencer to three, even with taking the loss, you're feeling pretty confident going forward.
Holy Cross really struggled to clear last time out in the loss against Bucknell. That was one way to do it right there. Just bomb it over everything. Worked out well. 17 for 28 on the clear last game. That's not a good number. Mullaney has a lane. Shot saved by Barreto. And the goalies have been very good so far, each of them.
Yeah, and you mentioned those clear stats in their last game against Bucknell, but the Crusaders cleared 15 of 15 in the upset win against Harvard, so they're capable of doing it.
Yeah, just struggled last game, and that time stopping an Army clear before it starts.
Yeah, Holy Cross always under Peter Burke is going to employ that ferocious ride. The Black Knights are going to have to be crisp with their passing out of the defensive half as well.
This is Spangenberg, ISO against Rigney. Rigney gets the better of him, and then the ground ball scooped up by Barreto.
Barreto led the team in ground balls in their last matchup, so he's certainly not afraid to pop out of the cage. Played in the highly competitive MIAA in high school in Maryland for St. Paul's. Their mascot, by the way, is also the Crusaders. And he's been a huge reason why Army has been so competitive. For them to be a ranked team this year after missing the Patriot League playoffs a season ago tells you how highly coaches around the country think of this Army team.
First time missing the tourney since 2004. So they were looking for that bounce back year, not used to struggling like they did last season. And so far they've gotten that. Just 1-1 in league play, but off to a 5-2 start against a very challenging schedule.
Well, and they usually do start well. A season ago, they won their first three, four out of their first five. Their only loss, 11-10, a three overtime game against Syracuse. And then they ended the season on a six-game losing streak. The only win after that first five was against Holy Cross.
It was like the Holy Cross game. The 5-3 game sent them into a bit of a tailspin. They never scored double-digit goals the rest of the season in any game and lost the remainder of the game. Shot clock is down here to 10. And that pass intended for Angle gets loose. Now there's 5 seconds on the timer. And it's going to expire now.
You got to give Will Murphy credit there, the long stick midfielder who's also played some close defense over the course of his career, just breaking up that pass. And that's what you got to do against Army. Just disrupt. Make them play your style.
What would you say are some of the defining qualities of Holy Cross's style under is another long bomb clear here. Interesting. All the way ahead to Kodzis. We'll continue that thought in a moment, but that looked like that was in the crease there.
Yeah, it was, and I think that's a good segue. They're opportunistic. They see that opportunity. They're not going to let Army employ their ride. Not that Army uses a 10-man ride all that much. Holy Cross looks to capitalize on other teams' mistakes. They did it against Harvard. They were down 10-3. The Crimson got sloppy. They scored eight in a row after that. And that's what Peter Burke has taught them to do. They focus in the offseason. He said all they want to do is get better every single day. And one of the ways to do that is learning to identify other teams' weaknesses. And right now, again, a long outlet pass, and it works.
Yeah, certainly figuring out a solution to their problems against Bucknell with the clear, and then maybe something they saw on film from the Black Knights as well. Outletting it all the way over the top. This is a loose ball, though. Linsky able to grab it. And then Holy Cross elects to call time.
I don't hate that decision from Peter Burke because nothing's happening. It's been a defensive struggle, as we thought, and he wants to reset and try to get the momentum early.
8:02 to go in the first quarter, and we are scoreless thus far. Holy Cross and Army here on Nesson Plus. Fans, this game is just the start of lacrosse action on Nesson Plus today. It's a triple header on Nesson Plus coming up directly ahead, another Patriot League matchup. This time in Boston, Bucknell at Boston University. Terriers looking for their first Patriot League win, just like Holy Cross is. And Bucknell, they got their first league win against the Crusaders last time out.
It's a very deep Patriot League men's lacrosse table this season. And BU's a team you got to look out for. Chris Gray, Towariton watchlist member, led the nation in scoring as of last week. And offensively, with their triple threat with Gray and James Burrs, their program's all-time leading scorer, along with Timmy Lay, going up against that Bucknell defense, that's going to be an absolute cracker at Nickerson Field.
Black Knights look tempted to push the pace whenever they've been able to take possession back. One early transition save made by Tesoro, and then there's been some bad passes like that one in other instances before Army can settle into their offense. This time, though, it stays with Army. With Pryor over there pursuing the loose ball, he'll now sub out. Junior Alacqua throws over to Garofano. Yorktown Heights, New York native Garofano. 5 goals, 3 assists on the season.
And one of those goals came against this Holy Cross team. He's one of the few that was able to solve the Crusader defense in that matchup last year.
Another pass gets away. Silva was the intended target. Manown, the junior midfielder from Rhode Island, races over for it. Shot clock is winding down again. 80-second shot clock in D1 men's lacrosse this year. Pass in traffic intended on the loose ball, eventually goes out behind, intended for Silva originally, but just 3 seconds to shoot now as it's dug up by Manown, and he's going to instead leave it off for Jones to try and probably pass in towards the cage or just leave it out there in the corner.
Yeah, and I think that's probably going to be the move. How about that effort by Conlon right in front of the cage to break up that first pass? He leads the Patriot League in cause turnovers per game. But on the initial play, it was Sean New, the junior, kind of the unsung hero of this defense, with Matt Farrell taking a lot of the headlines and Conlon kind of the new kid on the block. New, the Fox Lane High School product. It's the same high school as Keeley Connors, probably the best player on the Holy Cross women's team. So the Foxes have given the Crusaders some contributions offensively on the women's side, defensively on the men's side.
Well, this game has lived up to his billing so far. Yeah. All defense, middle of the first quarter. 0-0 is the score. Babiak's shot will be backed up. Couple of good looks per side. The goalies have been there at every chance, and otherwise been some forced turnover, strong defense. Spangenberg with it.
That was Babiak again playing through X. He scored the first goal of the game against Bucknell, a player that Holy Cross has looked to get involved early.
Look at that move from Mullaney, but the shot once again saved by Barreto.
Got to give Barreto credit there. It was a phenomenal swim move there by Mullaney, but then it looked like he rushed the shot a little bit, maybe almost surprised himself that that move worked, and Barreto had a clear line of sight the whole way.
Army crushed Binghamton in a non-conference game against the America East foe in their last game, 15-6. Big windup, and that shot got blocked on the way in from DeWitt. In the win against Binghamton, it was Miles Silva, who now leads the team with 17 goals. He had 8 in the win last game, including 2 different natural hat tricks, and that one sneaks in. Nick Turn gets it to go for the Black Knights, and it's 1-0 Army.
Well, in a matchup like this, Army will take it any way they can get it. Nick Turn, an opportunistic play. We talk about Holy Cross playing with that style. Get another look at it. He's trying to feed it in. Conlon does everything right to break it up, and that's just a tough bounce for Tesoro.
And naturally, there's been some high-quality looks that just haven't gone in, and then you get kind of offense by accident right there, and it happens to sneak through.
It might be the only way to beat these goaltenders. And you mentioned the game against Binghamton. The America East is a really interesting conference in lacrosse because it's one of the most top-heavy ones you have. You have Albany, who is a national power essentially ever since the three Thompsons were there. But then after that, crickets. Vermont had an outstanding season last year, made it to the final, and then Albany wins that game 14-4 and makes a run all the way to the NCAA Final Four.
Yeah, Albany's been able to really take the crown away from Syracuse as the top team in New York State, to everyone's surprise in recent years.
Yeah, and again, I think a lot of that credit goes to Lyle Thompson. He won a Towaratana Award and really elevated the popularity of lacrosse in and around the Albany area.
So far, Barreto with 4 saves. He is first in the conference, third in the nation in goals against average. Also leads the conference and is second in the country in save percentage. Delaware's Matt DeLuca leads the nation in both of those categories. This one right in front, and Silva was close, but Tesoro, the point blank stop.
Crusaders needed that in the worst way because they've been so good in every aspect of the game so far. Army gets a bit of a fluke goal, but if they go and score one like that, the feed in front of the crease was beautiful, and then Tesoro stonewalling Silva keeps the playing field level.
But now Holy Cross having a familiar problem of struggling to clear it after the issues against Bucknell. Still just a 1-0 game, but the Black Knights wrestling more of possession the last few minutes and getting that goal. Army averages close to 11 goals per game, gives up about 8. Middle of the pack offensively in the conference, but tops defensively. Wind up and a low shot, looked like a kick save from Tesoro on Alakwa's attempt.
We'll get another look at it here. Again, fed in front of the crease and an absolute rip, but can't find the twine, and Holy Cross is going to have to be better on their clears so far. And right there, it's just a little liner to Barreto.
Farrell just resorting to almost trying a shot, but Barreto was still pretty close to the cage, didn't really leave his post completely, and he was right there for it. Last couple times, what do you think might have changed as far as the ride and the clear?
I think Army's playing aggressively. I think they're using what their close defenders do, and they're channeling that with their attackers. And Holy Cross hasn't had an answer. These bomb outlet passes aren't working, and they haven't been able to methodically move it up the field.
Yeah, almost ever since that Holy Cross timeout, there's been some type of adjustment from Joe Albarisi in his 14th year for Army. preventing those bomb clears. Again, Silva with the try, and this will be backed up by Army this time. Well, Silva wants, he wants to eat some more. He had 8 goals last time out, looking for his first today.
Yeah, but Tesoro's not going to let that happen. Another terrific save. The shot clock will reset, and as we get into the end here of the first quarter, just 2:08 showing on the clock, Army wants to get a second. Give themselves some room, because if Holy Cross can sneak one in, you got a tie game, and you're giving a 2-4 team all the confidence in the world.
Silva again, stoned by Tesoro. Tesoro there once again as Manown got the rebound try. What a start from Jonathan Tesoro and A.J. Barreto in net for Army, for that matter. Spin move at X. Ball gets deflected on Nick Turn's pass. And here we go, loose ball again. New racing over for Holy Cross. Big lumber delivered by McKenna for the Crusaders, but eventually the Black Knights come up with the ball.
And that's a break for Army. They still have 57 to shoot. They can bleed this clock if they want to.
Loose ball and the trash picked up by Silva, and he deposits. Miles Silva, 8 goals last time out. Give him one more on his season, 18th to lead the team.
Well, if you ask Miles Silva, I think he'd feel like he deserves 2 or 3. At this point, but he finally gets it to go right there. Doesn't have an assist on the season, but again, leads the team. 18 goals. He's a third-generation Black Knight and claims to have wanted to go to West Point since he was 2. He is more than making the most of that opportunity right now.
The Floridian, the 6'4 junior, Silva, using his big frame, his physicality to get possession there and score it.
Well, and he only had 9 career appearances through his first 2 seasons at West Point, and now all of a sudden, he's become one of their most prolific goal scorers. So, an early candidate for breakout player of the year.
I mean, entering just last game, he had scored 13 career goals, and he's a junior. And he has now 9 since the Binghamton game began. 2 natural hat tricks in the same game.
That's going to be the answer to a trivia question in a couple of years. It happens more in lacrosse, obviously, than it does in hockey, but it's still, especially to have 2 in 1 matchup, it's rare.
Holy Cross able to get possession, looking to cut the deficit in half under a minute to play in the first quarter.
Talking about answers to trivia questions, Army is the answer to another one. They're one of just a few teams to share a conference with Holy Cross in 2 different conferences, obviously here in the Patriot League, also in ice hockey and Atlantic hockey. Black Knights are still playing. As they get set for their playoff run, the lacrosse team will be happy when that's over. They'll get Dalton McAfee back.
You got all sorts of trivia you're pulling out.
Yeah, every now and then. The other one's BU and Women's Hockey East and the Patriot League, of course.
Well, as long as it's Patriot League related, I'm sure our audience can appreciate it. Army's going to hold here with 15 seconds to go in the first. Nick Turn all the way across, and that shot sails out to the left by Alakwa, the Manhasset native. 7 seconds remaining in the first. Nick Turn behind the cage. Finds angle, and he just airmails to make it a Garofano. Pardon me. But lost that one way up high. And now this quarter is going to expire in a moment, and that'll do it.
Yeah, you'll take that if you're Holy Cross. The defense has been really good. Tesoro has been sensational. But offensively, the Crusaders have to find some way to solve Barreto, because right now the Black Knight defense is living up to its billing.
The defense has been supreme for Army, as advertised in the first quarter. Barreto, no goals allowed and 4 saves. Army up by 2 after the first quarter. Win against Binghamton, and now he gets his first of the game, beating Tesoro close proximity.
That hasn't been an easy task today. Tesoro, as we've mentioned a couple of times, has been spectacular, but when you get an attackman like Miles Silva right in front of the crease at point-blank range, eventually he's going to connect. And now the Crusaders need to get some of this momentum back. Who better to do it than Dan O'Connell?
So far, Holy Cross 2 for 3 on faceoffs. O'Connell is 3rd in the conference in faceoff percentage. He's won 65% of his faceoffs on the year. Going up against Barangin for Army, who's come on as the season has gone along, but O'Connell just making quick work of that one.
Well, Barangan's been a late bloomer in all aspects. He didn't start playing lacrosse till he was a seventh grader. And for a lot of people, especially in Long Island and in Baltimore, Barangan's from Illinois, but these kids are growing up with sticks in their hands. They're playing the organized lacrosse at four.
Yeah, maybe not in Illinois.
No, I mean,
quite as much.
He played some club for Baltimore Crabs. He's a well-traveled man. He found a way to play at the highest levels before heading up to Army.
Of course, lacrosse expanding out westward and certainly in the Midwest.
And he got a bit of a hot spot in Denver.
Mullaney with the crank, and that goes right into the stick of Barreto. Five saves for the senior from Darlington, Maryland, who at one point as a recruit was the number one goalie in the nation by Inside Lacrosse.
Yeah, that's not a surprise. You'll see all-stars coming out of the MIAA all over the place. You got Ryan Conrad right now at Virginia, and going back for UVA, Steele Stanwyck, another Towariton winner. He came out of Loyola as well in the MIAA. Stanwyck, of course, a member of maybe the most recognizable family in lacrosse, starting with sister Sheehan at Georgetown, and now the youngest, Shaq, Johns Hopkins.
Going top shelf there. That's a goal for Jones. Jones, the senior from Alexandria, Virginia, picks up his seventh goal of the season, and Army hangs three in a row on the board to start this game.
It's the captain that comes through this time for the Black Knights, and you got to put something special on it to beat Tesoro. And how about that one? Top shelf, bar down for the Alexandria native.
Jones, maybe overshadowed by Silva's eight goals, had a career high in his own right against Binghamton with 5 points, one goal and four assists, so doing more of the passing in that one, but able to connect with a goal of his own. O'Connell has been very good at the faceoff X, looking to take matters into his own hands a little bit, ends up setting up Kodzis, and there's an Army player down again.
And that is not what you want to see if you're the Black Knights, but good to see right away just popping up and walking around under his own power. That's Tom Rigney, the junior, another player who's really come onto the scene this year, just 9 career appearances prior to this season, but now one of the key members of this Black Knight core.
Has his helmet off, but he is off under his own power. Make sure you don't leave the equipment out there. And he looks to be okay, but have to sub out for now. Crusaders looking for something offensively. Waldron with the lefty shot. Again, looked like Barreto was there for it. Shot clock resets. Waldron regains control. Crusaders have the fresh 80.
Crusaders need a goal in this possession in the worst way.
Babiak, good stick work, still holding on to it. Now it's Spangenberg behind the cage. Looking for the pass across around the back shot. Waldron never got it there. And who last touched it is the question. Army did.
Sturdick might have got away with a cross check there as well, but the result's the same as if they call it. It stays with the Crusaders.
That was close, that opportunity out in the doorstep, but now Waldron another time. Kick save made by Barreto once again. Kodzis on the goal line. Whirls, and Barreto didn't see that one. It hit the crossbar, but that's all it was able to connect with.
And we'll get another look at it here. You're right, AJ. Barreto never saw that, and it just rang off the iron. Sometimes you got to be lucky to be good, and AJ Barreto's been outstanding and earned himself that break.
Trying the dodge up top was Mullaney, but he had that taken away. Clear cleared ahead to Horace. And the freshman from Easton, PA, takes it inside the zone for Army. What's the solution here for Holy Cross offensively? They got some very quality looks that possession, but just nothing would go.
I'm not sure there's anything you can really change there. There's not much you can do about a shot that clangs off the iron. That being said, we said in the first quarter that the key for Army is going to be to play aggressively without taking fouls. That is exactly what they've done. Holy Cross doesn't have a lot of lanes inside. They need to hope that some of these opportunities from distance can connect.
Davenport to DeWitt. Army making this Holy Cross defense shift back and forth. Now angle back to DeWitt. DeWitt has it knocked away from behind by Farrell. Farrell's over there to pursue it and does get the ground ball. So cause turnover and a ground ball there for Matt Farrell, the senior from Bernardsville, New Jersey.
Yeah, he's third in the Patriot League in cause turnovers game. Excuse me, fourth. He was also member of the preseason All-Patriot League team, the only Crusader to get that honor. And on the women's side, they had Keely Connors. On the men's side, Matt Farrell. And this is what Holy Cross has done. They found a way to get a couple of great recruits every year as Coach Peter Burt continues to build this program up.
Took over middle of last season. Interim head coach Peter Burke. Mullaney, as he was falling away. Again, Barreto was up to the task. And Serdik showing off his speed in the open field here. The outstanding defensive player for Army, able to clear it on his own.
He caused 23 turnovers last year. He's one of the best.
Oh, and Tesoro 1v1. Manau number one on the Army side with the shot. Tesoro scooped it right up.
And that's not a tough save. He didn't go high to low. He kept it high. Clean line of sight for Tesoro right into the pocket. Holy Cross will let Army take that shot 9 times out of 10.
On the clear, though, over the top, looking for Kodzis and out of play. Holy Cross is now 3 for 7 in clears.
Get a look at Peter Burke there, and that's going to drive a coach crazy because the Crusaders aren't playing against a team that's known for their ride, and for them to be that, to have that kind of struggles clearing the lacrosse ball, it'll improve, you figure it will, but frustrating early on.
Linsky subs on for Holy Cross. Now Babiak lost the ball going in there, just didn't even get hit. He lost the ball first before the contact. Tries to scoop it back into play and cannot.
Hounded there by Liam Davenport, and I think just Davenport's presence there was enough to disrupt Babiak. It's a terrific effort here to just do anything you can. You see this in basketball all the time, but another turnover.
Army began the year 3-0. Back-to-back one-goal victories over nationally ranked UMass and Rutgers. However, 2-2 since.
Yeah, and what a year it's been for UMass Amherst across the board.
Wind up in the shot from Garofano. Tesoro down low four. Tesoro able to make his eighth save for Holy Cross. There have been 11 saves already made by Barreto. Still halfway to go in the second quarter.
Yeah, Barreto's well on his way to shattering that career high that he set earlier this season.
That was in a losing effort against Syracuse, it seemed, that Army always seems to give trouble to, especially when they're the underdog. In this case, Army actually was the higher rated team coming in, so naturally the Orange won the game, but Barreto did have a career high 18 saves. But how about 11 saves, no goals given up thus far?
That's absolutely unheard of. Talking about how north of 50% is excellent, clean 100.
With that volume of shots, and there's the old announcer jinx. Linsky gets Holy Cross on the board.
Yeah, the broadcaster's jinx remains undefeated. Linsky going top shelf there, taking a page out of Nate Jones's book. Here's the replay, and we said that Holy Cross is going to have to find a way to connect from distance. Just goes over the cross there of A.J. Barreto.
the lacrosse gods wanted to know, just how much can you hype up Barreto's saves to goals allowed ratio? Okay, now, that was enough.
Now, take him off the field right now. Gives up one goal on 12 shots.
Yeah.
In all seriousness, though, Holy Cross needed that, because if you go down by two right now, midway through the second quarter, you're outstanding on the X as O'Connell looks like he's on his way to winning another one.
It's close this time, and actually eventually able to come up with it was Army's Condon. Still some defensive players out there for the Black Knights to look to sub in.
And that's James Pryor scurrying off the field right now, the freshman. Had his first two career goals in that Binghamton game, so just another weapon for a Black Knights team that's looking to establish itself on a more consistent basis offensively.
Yeah, kind of. That was one of those games you win 15-6, kind of everybody got a bite of the action in that one. Freshman who never scored before gets two. Silva gets eight.
But sometimes it's games like that that really turn out to be the breakout moment for these players.
It's over the head of Davenport. And it'll be Holy Cross with possession now. First three of the game going Army's way. Until on the 12th shot on goal against Barreto, the Crusaders finally strike.
And what Holy Cross needs to do now is keep their foot on the throttle. Not that Army's back on their heels at all, but they've now proven, even if everyone knew it, they've broken the aura that Barreto is unbeatable. And sometimes it's one of those situations where if you open the floodgates, the waterfall comes. The Crusaders have the offensive weapons to do it.
Linsky. Junior from Massapequa, New York, back to Mullaney now. Also a junior we highlighted in the open. Career high in goals scored in the season already this year. Now Spangenberg. Circle it back outside.
Spangenberg had the game winner against Harvard over in Alston a couple of weeks ago.
One of a long list of close victories the last couple of years. One-goal wins for Holy Cross. Under 20 on the timer right now. Waldron trying to bruise his way towards the cage. Spangenberg continues to hold. Bide his time. Under 5 on the shot clock. Got to do something. That's not what he was looking for. He lost the ball and the shot clock expires. To continue the thought briefly, though, on Holy Cross in close wins, you look at Peter Burke, who took over kind of co-interim head coach last year, gets the solo interim nod this year. He is 5-6 in his, you know, 2 years, one-plus years of action, and four of his five career wins have been by two or fewer goals, and two of the five have been in overtime.
Yeah, and you get the feeling that if they're going to win this game, it's going to be another matchup like that. Talked about how it was going to be low scoring. 3-1 right now with 4-plus to play in the second quarter.
We have a timeout, 4:23 to go. Two-goal game. Army struck the first three times. Holy Cross working their way back. Welcome back. This is the scene in Worcester. Fans still bundled up, although temperatures have been warming in recent days. In the 40s today, Army, defensive-minded team, holding Holy Cross off the board for over a quarter and a half until Justin Linsky, who had three goals and three assists against Loyola, was able to finally strike. This is what Army has coming up. Colgate is directly ahead. If Colgate can win today against Canisius and stay ranked, that'll be the fourth time in the first nine games that Army faces a ranked team, and they haven't even played Loyola yet.
Yeah, that's going to be an outstanding matchup because that's the equivalent of the unstoppable force meeting the immovable object, the best offense in the Patriot League against probably the best defense in the Patriot League.
Manown tries to throw over the top of the defense, and that did not work out. Will Murphy, the long pole, right there for it.
Murphy. Dad was a baseball player at Northeastern, and the Holy Cross baseball team is at Northeastern right now at Parsons Field for a doubleheader, really the first taste of baseball action in New England. A lot of these teams opened up their schedules a few weeks ago and made their southern trips.
Advancing all the way through, there's a shot from Conlon, the defender. And Barreto was ready for it.
You gotta believe Conlin's eyes were as wide as saucers right there, staring down his first collegiate goal one-on-one. Only problem is Barreto's a pretty good goaltender, as
that
we've seen.
That was Conlin's second shot of the season and of his career, the freshman from Chatham, New Jersey. Now subbing on, springing free a little bit there was Alakwa, but then Tesoro makes the stop again.
Talk to anybody in New England, they hear Chatham, they think Massachusetts.
Right.
The elbow of the cape. New Jersey's another one of those states that's kind of becoming a lacrosse hotspot. We've seen some really good players out of Basking Ridge, a couple out of Christian Brothers Academy.
With some great prep schools in that area. Just over 2.5 to go in the first half. Crusaders in a low-scoring game. Down by two after Army scored the first three. Babiak lost it, found it. Senior from Glastonbury, Connecticut. He had a minimal role his first few years on campus, but he's really picked up as of late.
It's been a common theme. Holy Cross isn't a program that plays a ton of freshmen. Logan LeBlond, one of last year's key attackmen, kind of the exception to that.
They were looking for Kodzis on the doorstep, but it got poked away. And this whistle's going to favor Army.
Even Matt Farrell really didn't play all that much as a freshman, became a regular starter as a sophomore, breakout player of the year in 2017, and now a senior and the best close defender they have.
I mean, I'll give you the one big exception on the team is the goalie. Tesoro is the guy who's been there, posted similar numbers too since his freshman year, now a junior. Been a pretty consistent player. Nice to have some consistency in net.
Yeah, I think Tesoro is really the exception that proves the rule. The fact that it was such a big deal that he played as a freshman, but gives one up right there.
Yeah, we have not been good for these goalies. Whenever we start to talk about them, then that means the goal's going in. 4-1 now, Army takes the 3-goal lead over Holy Cross, preventing a possible Holy Cross run heading into halftime.
Yeah, and tough play there for Tesoro, right on the doorstep in front of the crease. Silva goes low to high to low, and he gets his second of the game. That's 19 already. He's going to give Chris Gray a run for his money.
Just 4 goals for Silva on his career entering the season in 9 games played, and he's come alive in a big way the last 2 games now with 10 goals in the last 2.
You gotta believe Binghamton's having nightmares about the performance Silva had against them earlier this week.
Murphy picks up the ground ball, giving O'Connell the face-off win. Crusaders, though, still got it clear, and that didn't work out like they were hoping. George picks up the loose ball and thought about making an offensive attempt, but after the foray, he decides to give it back outside, and they'll get their offense out there. Shot clock no longer a factor. Army can hold here for the remainder of the half in a low-scoring game. That is what it appears Joe Alberisi wants to do. He calls timeout.
Yeah, why not? Holy Cross is going to have to find a way to respond in a big way, down by 3.
I mean, when you've held a team to just 1 goal through nearly the first 30 minutes of play, doesn't seem to be much of a reason to try and give them a cheap one here at the very end of the first half, right? Just trust your defense and hold on.
And it's not like Holy Cross isn't generating opportunities. Barreto and company have just been spectacular.
Here again is that Army schedule with Colgate up next. Then it is at Bucknell, home against BU of the Boston variety, and then at Navy for that always crucial rivalry game, Army-Navy, and Navy's a good team this year in conference as well.
Absolutely. Navy's historically been a good program. In the middle part of the 2000s, a couple of appearances in the NCAA Final Four, and we talked about how loaded the Patriot League is. Look at that schedule for Army. We haven't even mentioned Lehigh yet, and they were preseason number 2. They're ranked as well right now. They get off to a bit of a slow start, but really with Lehigh, we know about Loyola. Navy's historically great. Army is so good defensively. BU's got the three-headed monster on attack. you feel for Lafayette and Holy Cross and what these guys have to go up against every week.
I think what makes the conference legit is if you think about it, you mentioned how, like, the America East, they have Albany, but how much depth do they have outside of UAlbany?
Very little.
For the Patriot League, they actually have the biggest conference in the country, the most teams of any single Division I conference, and yet they still manage to be extremely deep.
They have to be, and what these teams do is they push each other to get better. Lacrosse, along with soccer, but especially lacrosse, was one of the big reasons why the Patriot League wanted Loyola so badly. They're the newest member of this conference, and honestly, it's done wonders for the other programs. With the exception of Navy, who is always kind of up there, it's elevated Lehigh. It's elevated Army. These teams are playing some of the best lacrosse they've ever played, and in some cases, they're just clawing for fourth in the conference. Especially when you consider BU just their sixth year of existence. This is hard to believe, AJ. Before that BU team existed, the only men's lacrosse team in Division I in Boston was Harvard. So it's just another opportunity for players to play at a high level in Boston. It's an easy sell. And BU, who also came from America East, has really, really elevated the Patriot League even more.
They are trying to reset the clock right now is the reason for the delay coming off of the timeout. And certainly it can always be used as a recruiting tool that can benefit everybody as well when you have a chance to play against a team like Loyola. And then ideally it just allows everyone else in the conference to rise up. And this is definitely, I mean, there's certainly at least one team that's routinely competing for a national championship in the Patriot League. And you may start to see more. And lacrosse is certainly a sport where any conference can produce a national champion. We know that.
Last year, Ivy League, it was Yale beating Duke in the title game. Lose Ben Reeves, but the Bulldogs are still competitive this year.
Not too many other sports where a team like Denver is competing for national championships either. So certainly the Patriot League has a chance to continue to get better in lacrosse. Garofano throws across the goal line. Loose ball again. Silva was right there in the mix, but this time there's a shove. And 4.3 seconds, looks like the score is going to stay 4-1.
And just to close the book on that anyone can win, on the women's side last year, you had an ACC team in Boston College who had never won before lose in the final to James Madison out of the CAA. And the Dukes said they were sick of being called underdogs. They were the number three team in the country.
Holy Cross, probably the underdog coming into this game, conducting themselves well in a defensive battle in the first half. Army by three at the break. Approaching the start of half number two, Patriot League men's lacrosse in Worcester. Army leads Holy Cross 4-1 after the first half of play with Dan McLaughlin, AJ Cannell here on Nesson Plus, and taking a look back at the first half. Defensive battle as advertised. The teams were held scoreless in the first 10 minutes before Army finally cracked the scoreboard. Brendan Nickturn. Holy Cross's lone goal of the first half was scored by Justin Linsky. But Army, they scored the first three goals of the game. Then it was, mostly about the goalies. Both double-digit saves in the first half.
And they've just been otherworldly. There's no other way to say it. Barreto made his first 11 saves before the Linsky goal. Army got off and running on a little bit of a lucky goal. Nickturn's shot got blocked by Conlin and then redirected in. But Tesoro's been awesome as well. If not for him, Holy Cross could find themselves in a 7-goal game right now. We expected a defensive battle, AJ, and we've gotten one. I think the key in the second half, we know what the defenses are going to do. It's going to be the highlight reel goals that are going to decide it, because we've seen it's been from outside or some incredibly athletic individual efforts in and around the crease. Not a lot of tic-tac-toe goals here in Worcester this afternoon.
Here are the numbers after the first half. Holy Cross leading in shots, but Barreto just been so good in net for Army. Began the game with 11 saves and no goals allowed in his first 11 shots faced. Crusaders the advantage in the faceoff X, but it has not been enough. Even with the more possessions and the shots advantage, it's not been enough to really crack this Army defense or come close to it.
Yeah, I can't put that on O'Connell, though. As you mentioned, he's been awesome, won 5 out of 7. His dad was an ice hockey player at Army, so this has got to be a fun moment for the entire O'Connell family.
Assuming his dad is going to make the exception and root for him.
You would think so. You'd think so, but hey, you never know.
Well, the good thing for his father, though, is kind of the Fogo's kind of, in a way, its own little island, right?
I love you and I want you to do well, but go Army. Yeah,
go win the face-off, and then Army can have the rest of it. That's kind of how it went, actually, in the first half.
Yeah.
Holy Cross gains possession again, and they'll back this shot up off of Kodzis's attempt. You know, sure seems like on the Army side that you mentioned how some of these, you know, rebound goals, just muscling your way in and just sort of make it work from close to the doorstep. Seems like that favors Miles Silva. He led the team with 8 goals last time out, and that crank from Mullaney's up high. That's how Silva has scored both goals in the game. Seems like he has a knack for just using his physicality in tight.
Well, and that's what happens when you put a big body in front of the crease. Yale won a national title with Matt Gaudette doing just that, and he won a tournament MVP honors for that performance.
Looking for Mullaney, it leaks through to Spangenberg. 14 to shoot.
By the way, Gaudette's back, so keep an eye on the Bulldogs late into the season.
Mullaney whirling, and the shot doesn't really have much on it.
Yeah, we say it's going to take shots from distance in order to beat Barreto. That would not be the textbook example of that.
Had to fire, though, late in the shot clock. And now Army, in close to a carbon copy of the start of the game, finally gets possession here after a couple of minutes of Holy Cross possession, but Black Knights went on to cruise most of the rest of the first half and control the game. Under Joe Albarisi, the 14th year head coach who came to Army in 2006 after the previous 9 years as an assistant at Duke. He'd also spent time at Army as an assistant under Jack Emmer, who he wound up replacing, the all-time winningest lacrosse coach in NCAA history at the time of his retirement.
Yeah, and that's the type of well-traveled coach that a program looking to build on itself needs. Got to see some outstanding talents at Duke with Matt Zash and Matt Danowski and company. Zach Greer as well. It's translated well to this Black Knight team, as you mentioned. All but one Patriot League tournament since 04.
Shot clock winding down for Army, and they're not going to get a shot off here. All the way out towards midfield as the horn sounded. Well, Army, in recent history, they're really known for 2010. When you look at the program's trajectory, they won their first ever Patriot League title that year. They beat Navy in the championship game and upset number 2 Syracuse in the NCAA tournament first round. Mention how Army, for whatever reason, over their history, has always had their way seemingly with Syracuse as Mullaney dives in, tosses over to Spangenberg, and they'll set up the offense now in a more settled situation. You know, it's not just recent memory or that 2010 upset for Army. All time in the program's history against Syracuse, they're 62-26. That's the number 1 winning percentage against any opponent, and the most wins for Army against any opponent have come against the Orange, as Kodzis yanks that one.
I think geography has a lot to do with that. I mean, there's some familiarity, but there's something about non-conference high-profile matchups that bring out the best in teams. If you look at Holy Cross, take away the men's soccer win against Duke, and the biggest wins in program history in non-conference games, especially lately, men's hockey against Providence, New England, women's hockey against Northeastern and against Harvard, New England, men's lacrosse against Harvard. It's local. It's geographic. Men's basketball against Harvard. There's something about playing a local team that really gets you up and going for it, especially as an underdog.
Army was quick to back that shot up. Now they are able to gain the zone. Manown draws some defenders. Tosses across for DeWitt. DeWitt to angle. That one ricochets multiple times after pinballing. Eventually, Jones, who had a first-half goal, comes up with it.
Right off the helmet of Conlin there, and everyone was trying to locate the ball that had skied.
Takeaway there, and steering it right to his goalie was Murphy. Will Murphy's been pretty productive today, it seemed like.
He's having a spectacular game for the Crusaders. He's getting in lanes. He's disrupting. He's forcing Army to play Holy Cross's tempo.
Crusaders may have to bomb it again to clear this one. That was a theme in the first half. Conlin over to Linsky. Army looking for a call there, but offsides.
It's as close as you're going to get, but the official right there. I think that's the right non-call.
Still got to get this inside the box. And now, finally, that must have been just in time.
Pretty casual there from the Crusaders, though. They knew exactly what they were doing.
Have that internal timer. Waldron facing tight defense again, as always, on this Army side. Now, Waldron gets it back. And that was a tough pass for Kodzis to handle. An unforced error.
Army's been so good at causing turnovers in this game. And if you're Holy Cross, you can't afford to beat yourself. And turnovers like that, first of all, it's a coach's nightmare. And second, you're giving a team that's forcing you into tough plays all game, you're giving them a free one and another offensive possession. And the difference between a 3-goal lead and a 4-goal lead in lacrosse is massive.
Even in a game like this, just 3 goals feels like more than 3, though.
You've only scored 1, yeah.
So low scoring, goals so tough to come by for either team. Again, a 5-3 win at West Point last year for Army over Holy Cross. This is nothing new between these two teams. Oh, how about the fullback move from Garofano, trucking the defender.
Doesn't end up leading to much, though. Army will throw it away right there, but they reset anyway. But what that does is it gets the bench going.
Yeah, gives you energy.
Get another look at this here. Garofano just walking in, held down the right joystick and put on the truck.
Maybe part of it, too. I mean, Holy Cross is also a very good defensive team, but you think about an explanation for why these matchups have been so low scoring between these two teams. You really just do the equation. Well, Holy Cross is a really good possession team, and Army is a great defensive team. So a lot of the game has been spent. Crusaders have had the ball, but just unable to do what they want to.
I think you hit the nail on the head, and just to kind of piggyback off of that, it's also the goaltending on both sides, because Army, yep, on their breakouts hasn't been able to connect on much, and Barreto stonewalled what shots have gotten to him.
Linsky has the lone Holy Cross goal, gets pushed, and you've been waiting for that, saying that really one path to Holy Cross to get into this game would be drawing penalties. We have not seen one yet until now.
Well, Holy Cross will go a man up. They're 18.8% on the season. See the drive here by Linsky, just forcing Army to make mistakes, and that's a cross check right there on Rigney. Good to see him back on the field as well after he was shaken up in the first half.
Good point. These two teams actually are tied for the fewest man-up goals in the conference on the season. Each team has 3. Holy Cross is 3 for 16. Army is 3 for 13. This will be just a 30-second penalty on Rigney.
It's actually going to be on Matthew Horace. So Horace taking down Linsky beforehand. The cross check happened, but it was after the fact.
Well, I think it's actually on both. They posted 2. Unless there was an error. Now, you know what? Maybe because it's 46 was posted on the board.
Yeah.
That's why I said Rigney, and now they've changed it.
Well,
so
there
that
was absolutely a cross check. I think the whistle blew on the call on Horace first.
So Horace, you could clearly see, is the one in there. So he's serving the 30-second penalty, of which about 7 seconds have gone by.
It's another Army legacy. Assistant Courtney, the captain of the volleyball team at West Point.
It's a very important sequence here for Holy Cross to take advantage on this short penalty. Down by 3 goals, only 1 goal in the game. Their man-up unit out there. Mulaney to Kodzis, shoots. Did not get a clean look, and the penalty has 2 seconds on it right now with the clock stopped. And now it's expired. Around the back shot, and the shooter, Linsky, got hit high.
And a little bit shaken up there is Linsky. Not sure he needed to go behind the back on that play. So we'll get another look at it. It's a terrific feed there from Spangenberg up to Babiak, and then, yeah.
But Kodzis shoots and scores as we come back to live action. So the penalty ends up getting Holy Cross going. Did not convert with the man up, but scored shortly thereafter. Kodzis gets his team-leading 14th goal of the year.
Led the team in 22 a season ago, and the Crusader of the Week back on February 25th after a five-goal performance in their win against UMass Lowell. He gets the Crusaders going here in the second half, cuts the lead to two. And Holy Cross is alive and going into their strength from the game at the X.
Been six goals scored between the two teams in the game. Five have been unassisted.
It's par for the course for how this game's gone.
Big see if O'Connell here. Can take this one, Dan, and give Holy Cross a chance to keep the momentum going. He's able to win that faceoff.
Baranjan stapled to his back there. A terrific individual effort by O'Connell and his teammates appreciating that.
Yeah, Baranjan came into the game at 64%, actually a spot ahead of O'Connell with fewer attempts, but percentage-wise, a spot ahead of O'Connell. Baranjan second in the Patriot League in faceoff percentage, but O'Connell has completely tormented him and dominated that matchup so far today, keeping Holy Cross in the game. There's a flag down, too.
It's going to be on Baranjan. It's got to be after that. You see him kind of hanging off on the sideline alone.
So with the delayed penalty, there's a whistle here, and that's going to end the delay.
Yeah, so it's going to be Baranjan that sits. Holy Cross will go a man up once again. And you mentioned how good he's been at the X this year. Smaller sample size. Army just 36.5% coming into the day at the X. So they're going with Baranjan because he's been so effective lately. But O'Connell has kind of welcomed the freshman to college lacrosse.
Another 30-second penalty, and even though Holy Cross was unable to convert, so technically, you know, they're 0-for-1 on the man up, it was certainly a productive penalty that freed up the offense. And eventually, I think there's a direct correlation between the penalty happening and Kodz's scoring just a few seconds after.
100%.
Penalty is halfway done on the Army Fogo. Babiak here with it. Tries the swim move. Penalty about to expire. 3 seconds left on it. Mullaney throws behind. Penalty comes to a close. Pryor comes back out there. It's now 6-on-6. Kodzis tries the bouncer, and Barreto is there.
What an outlet pass as well by Barreto to connect with Rigney.
Now Rigney running ahead on his own. Nice tic-tac-toe passing, but no clean shot able to get off. Nick Turn had it last and kind of lost it. And just like that, Holy Cross gets it back.
Whew, wipe a bead of sweat away from your forehead. If you're a Crusader right there, you get another man-up opportunity. Army kills it, and you're about to give the Black Knights the momentum back, and they can't connect their passes.
How about Kodz is stepping up? He scored the goal. He had the shot that nearly led to a second goal in this quarter, and then a one-man clearing effort.
Well, if Holy Cross wants to come back in this game, that's not going to be the last we hear from Kevin Kodz.
Linsky working his way through. He's able to score his second goal. Two straight for the Crusaders. It's 4-3 against nationally ranked Army, a one-goal game.
Now here's where things get interesting, AJ. All the momentum is with the Crusaders. The bench is alive. Linsky's on fire. He's got 2 on the day, 7 on the season now, as you see there. Going back to the faceoff where Army's going to switch things up here. Baranjan will sit, but O'Connell, so effective for the Crusaders. There's no reason to think they're not going to have a possession and the opportunity to tie the game while they're feeling themselves.
This is Evan Condon, who's only been able to win 28% of his faceoffs on the season. Struggled early in the year, replaced by Baranjan for Army. And it's been O'Connell all day for Holy Cross, the Winchester, Massachusetts native. And all comes down to who gets this ground ball. It's been knocked around for a while. Eventually won through by Chase Maitland.
It's another freshman, and what a time to make a contribution to this game. If the Crusaders are going to go up here, you feel like this is their chance. This is their window. Still a lot of lacrosse to be played. Army's back on its heels. The Crusaders are energetic. Seems like the breaks are going their way as well.
Ground balls are just about even, 20 for Army, 19 for Holy Cross now, and an evenly played game up to this point overall. Waldron spun off his spot, somebody looking to equalize this game on the Holy Cross side. Nice job on the ill-advised pass. Linsky able to scoop it up. Still with 35 seconds to work with on the shot clock here. Mullaney back to Linsky looking for the hat trick, and sprawling out was Barreto. That one, though, goes wide, so the shot clock doesn't reset.
Yeah, no harm there for the Crusaders. Still have 25 plus to shoot. You see the feed there from Mullaney. It's a nice pass. Mullaney's been quiet today.
To be fair to him, most of the team has been quiet until now. Waldron able to score. Three straight for Holy Cross.
And a rare assist in this game. That's tic-tac-toe. Nothing fancy about the play. Waldron finding a seam in the defense and not missing on the doorstep. Nothing Barreto could do. And what a time for Waldron to get his first of the afternoon.
As you see, eighth goal of the season already. The junior from Darien, Connecticut, has reached career highs in both goals and assists this year.
Spangenberg gets assist number 9 on the feed to Waldron up front. Haven't mentioned his name a whole lot. He's another player that's got a Crusader of the Week award already, and that's across all sports.
Spangenberg had a PG year at Phillips Exeter. Freshman from Dover, Massachusetts. Globe and Herald for both papers honored as an All-Scholastic player. Also was a 3-year varsity basketball point guard at Dover Sherborne. But Holy Cross comes back and scores the last three. They were down 3-0 and then again 4-1. And it's now even at 4. Barreto, who began the game with 11 straight saves and none allowed for Army, they're starting to get to him. As you said there, nothing he could do.
No, absolutely not.
Mullaney gets hit on the shot, and the shot is backed up by Spangenberg.
That being said, the optics are a little bit different. Holy Cross has scored on 4 of their last 6 shots on target.
And they've continued to hold possession. This quarter has just been exclusively on this side of the field.
I mean, they've been doing that for most of the game, but I think you're right, especially at this moment. They're starting to connect on some chances. It's significant that Holy Cross, you've talked about it, what a good possession team they are.
Maybe eventually, no matter how good you are defensively, you start to get worn down if you're carrying the heavy lifting for the entire game like this. Diving in across the side of the net was Linsky. 2 flags come pouring in after the play.
Looked like Linsky was dancing, trying to do anything he could to not fall into the crease, and what he ended up doing there was drawing the penalty. It's a terrific individual effort there by Linsky, who's already got 2 goals in this game.
Well, and he drew the penalty at 4-1 that led to the Kodzis goal that was just after the man up expired. Second penalty that Linsky's been able to draw kind of right on the doorstep like that.
And here we go. Holy Cross is just 18% again on the year. That's going to go down. They're 0 for 2 today, technically. This would be a good opportunity for them to break through. Again, they're riding high right now, as you see Peter Burke not thrilled about something. And that call's going to go against the Crusaders.
It's going against Linsky. So Army gets their first chance man up.
It's 2 minutes. It's a personal. Well, for Matt and Farrell and company, they need this stop in the biggest way.
We've been told it's non-releasable as well.
Yeah.
How about that for a start to the penalty? Now Holy Cross is going to play keep away for as long as possible.
Yeah, they have to. We got the horses to do it, but we've said how much they've had a hard time clearing today. No problem so far for Jack McKenna. The key's going to be to try to keep it with the short sticks as much as you can.
This is also where the shot clock changes things. Unlike in previous years, there's a limit to how long you can hold it. But still, 80 seconds is the majority of the penalty. And you know what? Kodzis says, let's go and try and score. And he does. Everyone figured stall ball. Kodzis says, no thanks. I'll take my second goal.
Can't forget the shot clock. How about a goal? The bench goes absolutely wild. Holy Cross takes their first lead of the game. You see this in lacrosse from time to time. It's not impossible to score when you're a man down, and Kodzis gets a massive goal for the Crusaders here.
Kodzis gets his second of the game. Penalty, obviously, with Holy Cross having scored the goal, not Army, is still in effect, and it's non-releasable anyway.
Right.
But 4 straight goals for the Crusaders. And Kodz is just taking everyone by surprise.
He out-sprinted Johnny Sertic. This is one of the best defenders, not only in the Patriot League, but in the country. He was a third-team All-American last year, and he just got taken to the house by Kevin Kodzis. Now a big face-off here as Army goes back to Barangan.
O'Connell. Able to win the face-off, last touch by Army. And it's been two things that we knew were strengths coming in for Holy Cross that have really helped them in this spot. They get back to 4-4, right? And you figure, okay, they might be in trouble now with a two-minute unreleasable penalty, but they immediately force a turnover, and then after scoring, win a big face-off.
And by the way, that penalty still has another minute 13 on it. And Holy Cross, right now it feels like they're a man up the way this field is erupted.
Yeah, they've held possession not only for the entire quarter, but for almost all of this penalty. Now they are able to hold essentially for the remainder of the penalty. The shot clock and the penalty clock are nearly in sync right now, and they both have about 50 seconds left.
Now we're going to see a game of keep away here for the Crusaders. You mentioned Peter Burke and his opportunistic style. If they see a seam, they're going to take it. But I think they'll be content to let Will Spangenberg just grace the perimeter of the field.
It's been a 4-0 third quarter for the Crusaders, expanding on that quarter lead during the penalty against them. And now it is the keep away.
Yeah, and essentially no differential between the shot clock and the penalty clock. It's literally a second. So if you're the Crusaders, just don't turn the ball over and you win this regardless.
They'll hand it back to Army with a little less than 30 seconds to go in the quarter. They might try and shoot here at the end, though, if they can, and then eventually Babiak just dumps it out of play. Penalty expires. Game clock has now frozen at 24 in the third quarter.
This is the biggest possession of the game right now, at least so far, because if you're Army, if you get one, you've weathered the storm, the game's still tied. This isn't a situation you haven't been in before. If you're Holy Cross and you hold them, you outscored Army 4-0, you solved one of the best defenses in the Patriot League and one of the better defenses in the country as well. At home, on a holiday weekend, a lot riding on these next 25 seconds.
Add a few seconds to the clock. This is the end of the third quarter here at Kuzneski Field. Bouncer pass gets all the way through to Horace. 10 seconds remaining in the quarter. Army looking to even the game up at 5 after leading 4-1 at the halftime break. Manoud through traffic, still holding, but time is going to expire in the third quarter. 4-0 advantage for Holy Cross in the third, including a man-down goal, the seconds of the game from Kevin Kodzis to give Holy Cross the lead. It's the Crusaders with a 5-4 advantage over Army. See if Holy Cross can keep it going heading into the fourth quarter. Welcome back on Nesson Plus with Dan McLaughlin, AJ Cannell at the start of the fourth quarter. Face-off violation against O'Connell, and it is Army possession with Holy Cross up by one. Scored all four goals in the third quarter.
And this is big for the Black Knights early in the fourth. What adjustments did they make? Remember, Army went on their first little barrage right after a Holy Cross timeout in the first quarter.
Didn't have much of a chance to possess the ball in the third quarter. So, you know, hard to blame some of their offensive players. Only more can they win faceoffs and then clear it after defensive stops. Loose out behind the cage.
Although they did throw away their one golden chance on the breakout right after they killed the first penalty.
Yeah, some sloppiness at times, turnovers. Angle shoots to Soro right down for it. You could see him tracking that one and just getting a piece of it.
Big save there by Tesoro. Holy Cross riding high coming into the fourth, and they keep it going.
Ooh, look open behind the play. Bounce shot, not quite for McKenna.
Barreto might have gotten a piece of that, and if he did, that's Army senior netminder stepping up in a big way as well. A beautiful feed for the Crusaders, and McKenna just missing his first of the year.
Entering the quarter, 13 saves for Barreto, 11 for Tesoro. That's right about where the numbers were at halftime.
Yeah.
I think it was 12-11 at the halftime break.
And remember, Barreto saved the first 11 shots on target that the Crusaders had, the one going off the crossbar. Resets the shot clock, but it is not a shot on goal.
That one was close on Mullaney's try. He's looking to get on the scoreboard.
Tough angle there, and Barreto makes another terrific save.
Linsky throws behind. Fakes by Spangenberg. He's still holding it. Spangenberg waiting for a cutter to come in to his liking. Still just holding. Turning into a little game here. Spangenberg just bluffing with the ball. Now finally takes it out from his station.
I think Spangenberg's plan that whole time was to roll around the crease and try to fire in on a wraparound. Army defended it beautifully. Pumped a couple of times as if he were feeding, but no real cutters.
No one was buying it. Still 30 on the shot clock. Drew Babiak with it. Holy Cross content to be patient at the moment offensively. We'll stop and start. Babiak right back to Spangenberg at X. Now does the wraparound. Tries to uncork it and cannot. And a timeout taken by Peter Burke.
That's the Army defense that we've heard so much about. And Peter Burke wants to make sure that they make these last 11 seconds count.
Looking to take advantage of this possession. Holy Cross with a 5-4 lead over Army. We're going to take the break here on Nesson Plus. Well, this game has exceeded expectations so far. Holy Cross, the underdog, looking for their first Patriot League win out in front. And now there's more to come on Nesson today. This is just the start of a lacrosse triple header. Bucknell against Boston University coming up. And Harvard is at Brown in the Ivy League. Well, here in Worcester, A.J. Cannell and Dan McLaughlin. Shot clock winding down, able to free up Linsky, but he tries going high to high, and Barreto right there with him.
There was daylight if he went high to low there, but that's a tough angle for Linsky. It's not a bad shot. I think the timeout was worth it. And give Barreto credit. He's an outstanding goaltender. He made a nice save. Now the Holy Cross defense has to step up again.
Defense got quite a breather most of the third quarter. We know how talented this Army team is, though. Kept in check in the third, but still just a one-goal game despite how much control Holy Cross has had in the recent going. It is Davenport over to Sean O'Brien. He had a man down goal earlier this year. Of course, Crusaders got one from Kodzis to take the 5-4 lead.
And O'Brien had a point in all but three games last year. He's been quiet today as well. We mentioned Mullaney on the Holy Cross side. Still a lot of names who have yet to be heard from looking to make their mark here in the fourth.
Pass in traffic around the back and in for the tie. Silva has done it all for Army the last couple of games.
Circus goal there for Silva. He's got the hat trick, and that barely snuck in. It kicked off the iron and ended up resting right on the goal line, a little bit beyond it, just barely sliding it in.
The around the back doink in for the hat trick. Miles Silva evens the score at 5 apiece. We got a good one here in Worcester. 20th goal of the season for Miles Silva, and after 8 against Binghamton in their previous game, he's got 3 in this low-scoring game. In its own way, very impressive.
Absolutely, and the way he's done it, it's been all physical. It's been all brute strength, but he adds some finesse right there with the behind-the-back goal, though he did have to bulldoze his way through to get the shot.
You know, with his ability to get these goals, like you said, off of brute strength, doesn't it seem surprising that he was held in check for really the first 2.5 years or so of his career? You know, he's a junior that he scored nearly half his career goal output in the last couple of games now.
Well, the highest hurdle for him was getting onto the field. He had to prove to Joe Alberici that he needed to be out there, and once he's done it, he's capitalized.
Under 10 minutes to go in the game, even at 5. Army scored the first three goals, also led 4-1. Then a 4-0 run for Holy Cross, and then the third for Silva, evening the score. Kodzis tries tough angle. This is going to be a race to back this one up. And it's close, but Holy Cross wins that race. Rigney was right there.
And typically the tie will go to the offense. You hear that in baseball all the time. Tie goes to the runner. That's awfully close, and if there's the doubt, it'll usually stay with the attack. And Holy Cross, the beneficiaries right there.
Crusaders have lost their last seven games against ranked opponents, facing the number 18 team in the country today in both national polls, inside lacrosse and the USILA coaches poll. Of course, their last win against the nationally ranked team was in 2015 on March 7th against, well, I'll let you guess, Army.
In a low-scoring game that is the only time Holy Cross has ever beaten Army. We said at the top of the broadcast, yeah, they're 1-27, but that one, relatively recent, although worth mentioning, nobody on this team was on that team. That was 4 years ago. So that was Logan LeBron's crew, and he was a freshman.
Takeaway there from Griffin Schultz, the senior from Lancaster, PA, who started every single game defensively this year for Army. A big part of the setup for both teams has been the consistency. All three defenders have started every single game for both teams.
And why not with the way they're playing here today? And just to close the book on that 2015 season, Holy Cross beat Loyola that year as well. So that's a season that Holy Cross has certainly looked on with some pride, but a program that continues to build itself, continues to try to launch into that group with BU and Bucknell, and eventually sky's the limit. Why not Navy? Why not Lehigh? Why not Loyola?
Tesoro stones Alacqua. As you mentioned, the 29th meeting between Army and Holy Cross, 27-1 Army record. They won the first 24 meetings ever. Currently on a win streak of three straight. But it as Army ends up taking it right back on Holy Cross's clear attempt. It shows you, though, you know, the 27-1 record all time. Some of those results way in the past in these series histories in sports don't always play that much of a factor. Clearly, this is a much more even matchup than the 27-1 would indicate.
Well, right. But that is one of the more interesting things about college sports is you can get rivalries that happened way back in the day. They go dormant for a while, and then welcome back. So with the women's hockey team this year for Holy Cross, they hadn't played BU since 2000. And now they'll see them three times a year in Hockey East.
Ground ball scooped up by Conlin. Last couple of minutes have been a little helter-skelter. Nobody has settled into an offense.
And the helter-skelter style 100% favors Army. Because Holy Cross, as we've talked about extensively here this afternoon, they're focused on possession, get a lot of opportunities, and eventually one will go.
It's this middle of the field that's given the Crusaders problems, but it looks like that's going against Army, and yes.
It is, and I think Army is extremely fortunate that that wasn't a more severe call than it was. We'll get another look at it here. Looks like a pretty clear slash. Crusaders will put it in the cross of Justin Linsky, and he's already scored twice today.
Close 5-3 loss for Holy Cross in the series against Army last year. Now there's a giveaway. Like, illegally done by Linsky. Long pole shot, Surdick looking for his first goal. What a dramatic way that would have been for Army to go ahead. The recent Major League Lacrosse draft pick, the star defender Surdick. You see the replay there.
Gonna be interesting to see if he chooses to go, because not only do you have the MLL and also the NLL, and now Paul Rabel's PLL as professional options. Remember, this is a military academy. He does have a service requirement, so it's going to be very interesting to see how Johnny Surdick approaches this. Certainly talented enough to play at the professional ranks.
Back-to-back All-American honorable mention in the preseason Patriot League Defensive Player of the Year. Johnny Surdick, number 40, the senior captain for the Black Knights.
And twice a Patriot League first-teamer over the last two seasons. An assist against Holy Cross last year. Wanted to get one for himself there.
goes through DeWitt. Nick Turn with it, 20 on the shot clock now. Approaching 5.5 to play in the game. Nick Turn feeding, and in close, Silva nearly won the race through multiple white jerseys, but Murphy, Johnny on the spot again.
Clutch ground ball there for Murphy, who played his first season of collegiate lacrosse at Skidmore as a long stick midfielder, playing a lot of that role with the Crusaders, played some close defense as well, and maybe the best defensive player for Holy Cross here today.
He's looked really good, but again, Holy Cross has completely lost their ability to clear in this fourth quarter. And so it's just left this game kind of hanging in the balance here. Army still yet to get things going, but unlike the third quarter when Holy Cross controlled it on their end, that right side of the field on our camera screen has not been kind to either team.
No, it really hasn't. Army's got the one goal from Silva in this quarter, but this has been the sloppiest played quarter so far, which can be really exciting as a fan. It's incredibly frustrating as a player. I think both teams are happy to still be in this game, and honestly, AJ, we might be at a point where the next goal wins.
Well, this low scoring a game, you're probably right. Timeout call by Army. 5-5 game.
Yeah, it's not exactly a hot take there.
Yeah, I was going to give you some trouble for it. I'll let you do it.
I mean, honestly, though, yeah, sure. But at the same time, just because it's obvious doesn't mean it's not true. These are two teams that are playing outstanding defensive lacrosse right now. Two goaltenders that have found their mojo in the fourth that they had early in the game. Tesoro really hasn't had a stretch where he's struggled. And it's hard to pin some of the goals on Barreto. But again, giving up 4 goals in a quarter, tough.
Here is what Holy Cross has in store. They play at Brown in a non-league game on Tuesday. Then the other Service Academy, Navy, coming up also on Nesson Plus on Saturday on the 30th. And it's at Lafayette. And game against Colgate coming up as well.
Well, if you're a Holy Cross fan and you're joining us here this afternoon on Nesson Plus, stick around because that Brown team's playing at 4 against Harvard. You'll get a look at the Bears there against a team that Holy Cross has been familiar with before the Crusaders head on the road to Providence.
And the two BUs are directly ahead after this one, Boston U and Bucknell. This is our Super Saturday Nesson Plus lacrosse triple header. What's in store for you? And if game one is any indication, got some exciting stuff. I mean, this has been an excellent start to that triple header with the teams going back and forth. And, you know, Army looking to avoid heading into a tailspin down the stretch of the second straight season. You mentioned how last year they lost their final 6 games after a 5-2 start. Guess what their record is right now? They're 5-2 under Coach Alvarisi this year. And it was the game against Holy Cross last year. Kind of a slow-moving, low-scoring. Harmony won the game, but they did not win again the rest of the year, looking to avoid that this year.
Yeah, the Patriot League has not been kind to the Black Knights recently. We mentioned the depth in the conference, and a team that is this talented can tailspin if they're not careful. They did end their season at Notre Dame, but for the most part, it was all conference losses.
This Holy Cross team, on the big picture, you know, they've struggled, obviously, in the Patriot League, for those that are familiar with it, as 10 seconds to shoot here coming off of the Army timeout. Manown up high, and it's stolen up there by New.
The Bedford, New York native elevates, but it's going to be given right back to Army.
Yeah, there was a push somewhere there that gave it right back to Army. I was going to say that if you look at the conference win totals the last few years for Holy Cross, definitely improved compared to other previous seasons. See a little replay there. And Crusaders making the tournament back-to-back years in 2016 and 2017 was a big accomplishment. Struggled a little bit more last year and looking for a bounce back this season, but off to an 0-2 start under interim head coach Peter Burke.
And we talk about how they're a veteran team for the first time in a while, and they are, but remember, Waldron, Kodzis, Mullaney, all juniors. So they're going to be back next season. This Holy Cross team, they do lose Farrell. Spangenberg's a freshman. Tesoro will be back. A lot to be excited about here on Mount St. James.
One of their three defensive players, defenders, Conlin comes back as a sophomore next year, just a freshman this year.
And they'll get Linsky back as well. It's going to be a very senior-heavy team next season.
Reset the shot clock to 80. 3:35 to go in the game. Army with control. Nick Turns slips. He's got two defenders there. And Army's bench call timeout while Nick Turns still had control.
I think that's smart because that was a terrific effort by Matt Farrell, the senior, showing why he's earned this conference recognition in the preseason. And even though Army maintained possession, they were in complete disarray. That is a veteran move by Joe Alberici to kind of reset here for the Black Knights. Knowing they have possession, they have 70 to shoot. You have the timeout. Why not use it now?
Now, the one thing that you'd have to think would help for Holy Cross is the familiarity with playing in close games. Mentioned how four out of Peter Burke's five career wins have come by two or fewer goals. Army, one of the four ranked teams in the Patriot League, sitting at 1-1 in the conference. Three unbeaten teams left at still this early juncture in Patriot League play, and Holy Cross looking to improve their Patriot League win-loss record an inch closer to tournament contention.
I think that one of the biggest surprises on that standing graphic is Loyola being 4-2. They were the number one team in the country for quite some time early in the season. Then they lose to Towson, a local rival. It's another one of those out-of-conference geographic games that I think the Tigers really got up for. Towson had a brief stay at number one. It now belongs to Penn State. And Loyola has sunk. They lost again. They're now the number eight team in the country, but make no mistake, Pat Spencer and company, it wouldn't shock us to see them run the table the rest of the regular season. Holy Cross gave them a game, though, a 19-15 result down in Baltimore.
Yeah, and really, I mean, that game was every bit as close as that final score would indicate. It was a one-goal game entering the fourth quarter. Impressive for the Crusaders to hang around with them and score all those goals, but facing a nationally ranked foe for the second time this year now, two games later against Army, it's 5-5. Tesoro with the lightning quick reflexes on Garofano's attempt.
Yeah, the Ridley Athletic Complex has been kind to the Crusaders. Their men's soccer team got a penalty shootout win against BU back in 2017 to go to the Patriot League final. And the lacrosse team proved down there, they got a big win against them in the snow in 2015 that we alluded to earlier. They proved they can compete. That Loyola team is so strong, and it's given them confidence. I think that game is part of what's given the Crusaders the idea that they can compete with Army, and look what they're doing now.
Yeah, but Holy Cross just cannot clear it in the fourth quarter. Babiak was put in a tough spot, and he had it quickly knocked away from him. There's also a flag down now. So with the shot clock at under 60, Army with 2:26 to go in the game, they can take their time here, try and score one of the delayed penalty, knowing that they have the penalty coming up with limited time left in the game. As you said, Dan, one goal looks likely to do it the way this game has gone.
Crusaders have scored once, a man down.
And on the delayed penalty, Nick Turns scores for the second time today. They'll make it Jones. It was Jones to take the lead for Army. Jones is second as well with 2:03 to go. And the flag down, it was 6-5 now. Army back out in front.
And how much can Holy Cross ask out of Dan O'Connell? He's been so good on the X this season for the Crusaders, especially here this afternoon. And now he's got to win another one here.
And then secure possession afterward for good, too, with the way the Crusaders have had trouble clearing it. So the penalty gets wiped out.
The Army will take the goal for sure. The wings haven't been a huge factor off the faceoffs here today. It's been mostly the men in the middle.
And mostly O'Connell.
Yeah.
The junior from Winchester, Mass.
Although you remember the big ground ball picked up by Chase Maitland for the Crusaders in the second half.
O'Connell has his way with it again. Now it comes time just to clear it. Uses the speed, gets across half field, and will get off.
Just a simple roll dodge there for O'Connell. He does his job. Now the Crusaders need to settle down here. They need to focus. They need to find the seams and drive in.
How do you find a rhythm, though, offensively when you haven't had the ball here for most of the quarter?
That's why you got to be opportunistic. I'm not saying throw the playbook out, but look for seams that Army inadvertently gives you. Got so much talent with Kodzis and Linsky and Waldron. Someone will find their way open.
Army has scored the last two. Under 90 seconds to go in Worcester now. Out to Mullaney. 35 to shoot. Mullaney gets one off. It gets hit on the way in and connected hard with Babiak. An unfortunate break for Holy Cross. And now they're going to have to try and cause a turnover.
Shot clock's a non-factor as well. Army gets 80 fresh and only 68 on the game clock. That's a tough break for the Crusaders. They created an opportunity for one of their best goal scorers in Mullaney, and Babiak, who was almost setting a screen, takes the brunt of it.
1 minute to go.
10-man ride for the Crusaders now.
That was a key pass from Barreto up to DeWitt, and he takes it inside the zone successfully, so the clearing timer no longer a factor. Now, it's just a matter of can Holy Cross get the ball back? And that's a goal from Jones first. Jones has the hat trick. He scored the last two, and Army leads by two with 42 seconds remaining.
Well, that's a veteran play there from the senior Jones. Tesoro's out playing defense, continuing the 10-man ride. The Crusaders had to cause a turnover, although in some ways that's not the worst thing, because Holy Cross can win a faceoff and get the ball back now. It's not ideal, obviously, but...
I think normally I agree, but in this game, you're talking about scoring twice in 42 seconds.
O'Connell's got to win it clean.
Yeah, they have to score immediately here and then go do the same thing.
Yeah.
It does potentially give possession back to Holy Cross with a chance, like you said. O'Connell checks the first box. And gives it off to Linsky. 30 seconds to go. Linsky fires, backed up. This is going to have to happen really quick. Will Spangenberg gets a little screen. 20 seconds to go, two-goal game. Kodzis tries the shot. That won't go. And now, very limited time left.
If you're Army, you got to swarm the crease here. Let the Crusaders do whatever they want through X. Let them do whatever they want around the perimeter.
Got to score two goals in 10 seconds. They get one! Waldron! And there is enough time left to get one more. Barely.
2010, Duke won a national championship in overtime against Notre Dame. They won the faceoff, drove right down the field, and scored. This is not unheard of. It's a terrific quick stick from Connor Waldron. And now Dan O'Connell has to step up one more time. He's got to win it clean, but they need it right now. And the Crusaders, they've got a flair for the dramatic. They did it against Harvard, not in this scenario, but still something that looked impossible at the time. Game's not over yet.
O'Connell's been winning most of these by rolling back. So that's going to take an extra couple of seconds. The clock gets reset to 10.8.
And that's interesting. Do you change it up and try to kick it forward? Do something you're not as comfortable with?
I mean, you almost have to, right?
We'll find out.
10.8. Condon is out there for Army. O'Connell wins it forward, takes the ball, rushing towards the cage, shot saved, and then ultimately covered up by Barreto. O'Connell nearly did it himself, but instead, it's a 7-6 down to the wire win for Army.
What an effort there by O'Connell, just not quite enough. Barreto, who was so good in the first half, can't quite do it.
What an ending that was, Dan, with, as we sort of forecasted there, O'Connell deciding, yes, I got to win it forward. He won it. He got a clean look off, but Barreto, who'd been standout most of the day, wound up solving that final shot.
It was a terrific play all around, and you guys are going to get to Nickerson Field for the start of Bucknell against Boston University for a 2 o'clock faceoff.
17 saves in the game for A.J. Barreto. 14 for Jonathan Tesoro on the opposite side for Holy Cross. Really impressive defensive play for both teams and both goalkeepers most of the game. And it results in a 7-6 victory for the number 18 Army Black Knights over Holy Cross. The Crusaders fall to 0-3 in league play. The Black Knights improve to 2-1. Their record in conference play. Army has still beaten Holy Cross all but one time in their 29 games against each other, with a final of 7-6 once again here at Kuzneski Field in Worcester.
Man, did they have to work for this one, AJ. But a grinded out win for the Black Knights. They avoid the 5-2 curse. They get the win against the Crusaders, and we'll see what they can do the rest of the way.
So for my broadcast partner, Dan McLaughlin, I'm AJ Cannell, saying so long from Kuzneski Field, where the final score is 7-6 in favor of Army.